Addressing journalists during the weekly party briefing at Najana Nkumbi, the deputy president of the FDC party in Eastern Region, Margaret Madande, explained that they will hold a national council meeting of the party, which among its main objectives is to push for the reconciliation and unity of the party members this week on Friday. The reconciliation committee, which has been set up, will invite all the aggrieved party members and hold talks on how best to put aside the differences and build a vibrant party.
If they are real members of FDC, there is also a committee. By the way, the party has set up a reconciliation committee. Those members will be called and then talked to, and then their issues will be addressed. That we are very, very optimistic.
Though the reconciliations have previously failed, Madande is convinced that this time around they will be fruitful. However, she insists that in case they don't conclude, they will be left with no option but dismissal of the party members who will continue to defy the party orders.
People will be called in the reconciliation committee. If they refuse, then issues will be referred to the disciplinary committee. Then it is now the disciplinary committee that can pronounce themselves and say this person is persistently hostile and the actions are defaming the party. We need to dismiss the person.
In the same development, the FDC Katonga faction has also held a press briefing today where they gave an update on the ongoing power structure elections. The interim secretary general of this faction, Harold Kaija, confirmed that they are moving on smoothly and nothing will stop their delegates' conference, which is slated on 15th of March next year.
Tubakunga, musemu amanyi, tuweba zabo na dara, abatademu, obude amanyi, nakasente kabo, kubanga bintu ebisinga.
The dispute in question was about what was named the dirty money, where Dr. Chiza Besigye accused the party's Secretary General Nathan Nandala Mafabi of receiving money from the ruling government. Report compiled by Juliet Namwaya for the news.